पहली बात है
द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज
मैं भारत के संदर्भ में कह सकता
हूं आई कैन से यू इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ इंडिया आई रियली डोंट वांट टू टॉक अबाउट द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड
हमारे देश में बहुत पहले
इन आवर कंट्री देयर वाज एन इंसिडेंट मेनी इयर्स अगो इन कांदाहार वन ऑफ आवर प्लेन्स वाज हाईजैक्ड And there were many hundred passengers on that aircraft. The terrorists had kept them captive. But at that time, electronic media was very new. There was a television. And the citizens, they really talked a lot about the sufferings of the victims, etc. That it actually increased the courage of the terrorists. They believed that there's so much pressure on the government. Definitely going to give in to our demands. And I remember very well that the television media had a meeting at the time, and they decided to make a self-assessment of all the mistakes they had made and how they could actually correct them. And I thought that was a good initiative, but that sort of thing doesn't happen anymore. There's a lot of competition now. They want to give news out very quickly. They want sort of a sensational news. So there's a sort of an era of competition. So I don't know whether this is really going to reform itself or not. Social media has given a very big strength for empowerment. Today, any person can put a message out there. So it is a very powerful instrument of a democracy. But unfortunately, there is in an organized way negative propaganda is being done. It is good that every media today is trying to highlight fake news. They're spending 10-15 minutes a day highlighting fake news. So every day the social media and regular media, if they continue to focus on fake news, I think there will be an improvement in the situation. And the secondly, this fashion of forwarding messages, I think technology needs to find a solution that whereby there is some possibility of verifying news before we forward it. But I am myself very active on social media for many years, and I have had benefits as well from it. But I can see that if a small incident that takes place in a faraway village, I come to know from social media about it and I can very quickly trigger action. I don't need to make a statement. I can start action. But for good governance, the information that we get from the local level, social media is extremely useful for that. And I believe that if governments are sensitive, if they have a motto of good governance, then for information, social media can be an excellent tool. And the same way, if you had a flood, for example, in our country, when I was in Gujarat, there was a river, there's a river there in Gujarat, and once in 5 years there is a flood. But once, there was five floods in a single year, and the government machinery kind of was unable to cope. But I had the social media network, and I used to send messages out. We didn't really have the ability to send messages in many languages. So I used to use Roman characters to send messages in Gujarati. There was a single in a single year, we had five floods. There was some damage to property, but we did not lose a single person, and we did not lose a single animal. And therefore, this was through social media. So I think that for good governance, social media can be used in a very positive manner. So as a leader, if you say,
I
believe that social media can be used as an excellent tool of good governance, and I am doing a lot in this area as well.